and talk about this because of the machete attack that happened just earlier this week, I think it was, or last weekend in Denver. And it's not altogether uncommon. A lot more common if you travel overseas in less developed countries, particularly the more tropical regions. Everybody's got a machete. Kids are born with a machete in their hand. If you don't have a machete in your truck like I do, you should probably have one. Here's our very well-used machete from my truck that they keep with me at all times. Never know when I'm going to get attacked by some grapevines or something. But they're pretty common. So let's talk about this. The machete defenses are going to look like or be very close to our stick defenses, our overhead or our sideways swing stick defenses. Of course, the difference is it's basically a stick with a sharpened edge. Like stick, I don't want to create any right angles against this. If it's a stick or a bat, I'm going to break some bones when I create right angles. If it's a machete, it's going to cut or chop. So just like stick, I want to make sure that I'm creating a ramp to guide the machete or stick off my body. So when it attacks, I'm making my defense, protecting my head, my neck, my vitals. I'm building a ramp with my arm. If anything, my arm takes a little bit of impact from the bat or the stick, or it might even take some cuts from the machete. But better to take cuts on the outside of my arm than to take cuts here on my neck or my shoulder or my head. So I'm just kind of trading damage. Better damage, worse damage, where am I going? With the machete, my goal now, if at all possible, is to make the defense as early as possible and get as deep as possible. If I sit here and I'm late and I make this defense against my arm, then I mess up my nice dress shirt and I get cut along the arm. Again, it's a trade-off in damages. If I can get even just a little bit further inside, I can make the defense against the attacker's hand or arm now. The further in I get, and the sooner I get there, the better. Because Nate can always, or the attacker can always, shorten up on that stroke. So if he's reaching for my head here, freeze, and I end up here, it's not impossible that Nate changes the angle of his attack and still makes contact with me. Simply by shortening up his elbow distance on the swing and doing something like this. So I'm aiming as deep as I can, get my head in, keep that arm against the side of my head. If you can see from this angle, there's no space between my arm and my head. And I'm going to default with my arm coming across the center line just a little bit. And I'm aiming for maybe his elbow. Now Nate's swinging slowly, I'm moving fast. So it's not fair. The idea is that Nate's attack is probably going to happen before I can even defend. So Nate steps in to make a faster attack now, and I have to get in deeper. But here's the bonus. Nate's stepping in to make the attack. If I keep this distance and Nate doesn't move at all, he swings, he's never going to hit me. We're too far away. So as he's closing the distance, I take that as my cue to go towards him. He steps in to attack, I burst in as well, and now we're here. I've gotten deep enough to defend myself. Even if Nate decides to short stroke it, as he steps in, did he short stroke it?
Yep.
I couldn't see. I was defending. I'm still getting deep enough to make the defense. How do I assure that that's going to happen? Well, I'm probably going to play a little tactical defense as well. So I'm probably back up a little bit. I'm likely to, if I think I need to make a defense, I'm likely to sucker him in a little bit more. I want to be out here and even maybe move back. And now he thinks he's going to have to really commit to come and get me because I'm moving backwards. As soon as he makes that step and that commitment, boom, I burst forward. And I can even catch the attack before it's even begun its downward swing. If I can suck him in deep enough and make him believe that he has to chase me, I might move back before I move forward. Let's recover the main points. Burst in deep. I'm using the same side arm as his attacking arm. My arm goes first, my head gets inside of my arm, my body leans forward, and then I move my feet. I'm trying to go early and deep. No space between my head and my arm. And of course, once I make some kind of redirection and a simultaneous counterattack, probably 80% of this defense is this punch. I wrap, control, counterattack until I can affect some kind of takeaway. Come to class, expert level classes, we'll deal with this more. We'll talk about this control, the attacks and the counterattack and all of that. But that's the basics of machete defense. If you have any questions, comment on the feed. Comment underneath the feed here. The video, I believe, stays on Facebook in our group. So feel free to comment and ask questions, and I'll see what I can do to answer them. Thanks for joining us.